What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 72 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Heart Gold. We're finally in Cerulean City. We have tracked the thief who stole the part from the power plant here. He's hiding in the gym, but first things first, we're gonna go ahead and get rid of some stuff in our inventory here. Got a lot of stuff I need to drop here. Go ahead and get rid of these. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Caught myself there. Almost got rid of my max elixirs. I can't afford to part with those. That's how it happens when you rush. You start just pounding the button and you just are not aware of what's happening until, well, almost until it's too late. I've got almost a quarter mil right now. Anything else I can sell? I want to sell my TMs. Barely use them, but I do want to hold on to them. Get rid of my X items. I don't need those. I am, however, going to pick up some Quick Balls, just in case I run into a Pokemon that's not on my Pokedex. Odds are, off my team, if I try to fight a wild Pokemon, I'll just kill it in one move. That way, with the Quick Ball, I can try and catch it right at the start. This guy's a Team Rocket Grunt. Didn't we get rid of them a while back? See where that thief went? He's going towards the cape, towards the north. Okay, so that's where we're headed. Do want to check one thing out here first. Hopefully there's some hidden items. Yeah, it's a hidden item, but it's down in the water. Hey, the cave he was talking about was Cerulean Cave, the cave where you can catch Mewtwo. Pretty much the toughest dungeon in the original Red and Blue games. This guy's making a feeble attempt at hiding. Why'd you push me, Espeon? Bad Pokemon. You know, Espeon, if you want to push somebody, why don't you push this guy around? This guy's got a gold bat, you can take care of him. Need to let loose some aggression? How about a psychic attack? Lights out. Well, you got a level out of it, level 51 now. Alright, so you give back that part now? Okay, so he's hidden the part in the gym. Yeah, and I've already taken care of your boys. You know what? I'm not going to worry about them. You were the last one standing, and now you're completely finished. Alright, so before we head back to the gym and recover that missing part, I'm going to search for a couple of items with my dowsing machine here. I believe we can pick up a couple. First things first, let's repel. And I do believe we have to surf a bit to find it. Right here, we got a nugget, 5k in the bank. And here is Cerulean Cave, what I was talking about. We won't be able to go in here until we've gotten all 16 badges. Still got a ways to go on that. Alright, making our way back. I believe there's one more item we could pick up all the way to the north here. And right here, we got a revive. Okay. Okay, so I think I've found all I need to fight at this point. So, let's head to the gym and find that missing machine part. He said it was near an inflatable tube. I think it's going to be on the rear side of the gym. As you can tell, this is a water-type gym. Misty is the trainer here. We'll be fighting her probably later on. Maybe in the next episode or two. Yep, there it is, the machine part. So we can go ahead and take that back to the power plant. Alright, so let's head back to the power plant. Apparently I can't fly back to the power plant, it looks like. I'm gonna have to walk or run. Well, so be it. Alright, we've already taken care of all the trainers on this route. So, don't have to worry about them. Gonna need to put on my rappel again. Don't want to be interrupted by a pesky, weak Pokemon. Alright, Gyarados, let's take to the water. Oh, power plant special delivery. One machine part. And that will unlock a few other things that we're going to check out in this episode. We've got TM57, which I believe is the electric move Charge Beam. Don't know how that compares in terms of attack power to discharge. I may teach that to Ampharos later on. Anyways, we're going to fly back to Lavender Town. Gonna pay the Radio Tower a visit. Now that we got the power running, I think we can get the expansion card, which will give us the ability to eventually catch Snorlax, which we'll do later on in a later episode. And I do believe also later on, I think after we beat the game, we can also get the Hoenn and Sinnoh Sounds cards, which will basically enable us to start catching Hoenn and Sinnoh Pokemon. Alright, next stop is going to be Saffron City. We need to pay the Copycat a visit so we can get the pass for the Magnet Train. And right up here is the Copycat's house. Don't need the rappel anymore. Okay. Okay, so apparently the Poke Doll I had was not what she was looking for. We're going to head back to Vermilion City to find it. And I think I may have an idea of where it might be. Got to go through this little route first. And apparently had to take out a wild Pokemon here. Level 13 Pidgey. Not worth my time. So I'm just going to stick to the roads. Back in Vermilion now, and I think we're going to pay the fan club a visit. I believe I see a Poke Doll here. They gave us the lost item without incident. So now we can head back to Saffron. Well, who's this guy? This is Steven, the champion of Hoenn. Remember him from the Diary of Pokemon Trainer, my run of Pokemon Emerald I did a while back. Now, I believe Latias can start appearing in the wild. If you're playing Soul Silver, it'll be Latios. And I believe, like Raikou and Entei, this guy may appear completely random. Yeah, I got lucky to get both Raikou and Entei during my run in the, honestly, the last spots I would think to look for them. And you know what? The underground passage is open, so let's look down here. Maybe able to find a couple items. The dousing machine's going yellow here. We got an X special. Let's talk to this guy here. My parents are going to go ahead and take our Rage Candy Bar off of us here. Been wondering what to do with that. And we got TM64. And judging by his description, I believe that move is Explosion. And that guy needs to take a chill pill. And we got a full restore as well. Thank you, Dousing Machine. Always good to get one of those for free. And this will put us on the route in between Cerulean and Saffron. A route which we haven't explored. Honestly, there's not much here. No trainers. And just one building and a few grassy spots. Probably not worth anything. Yeah, just a level 14 Pidgey. Now, this house used to be a daycare in the original Red and Blue games. Now we can get a cleanse tag. I believe if your Pokemon is holding it, it'll repel Pokemon. However, I don't want to waste a held item slot on my party. I'll just use repels. Anyways, let's head back to Copycat's house and give her back her missing Poke Doll. And she promised us a Magna Train pass. And she kept her word. So now we can travel from Saffron to Goldenrod and vice versa. Just by riding the magnet train. And I think I've accomplished all I've wanted to do in this episode. So I think that'll be a good time to call it quits. Next episode, we're going to head to Cerulean Cape and search for Misty, the Cerulean City Pokemon gym leader. And get to challenge her either in the next episode or the one after that. Depends on how long it takes me to find her. So until we meet again, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.